हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, साई राम, वेलकम बैक टू सोशल स्टडीज़ क्लास। चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे विल बिगिन विद अ न्यू चैप्टर, ओके? बट बिफोर दैट, एज यूजुअल, लेट अस डू वन एक्टिविटी। सो हियर ऑन द स्क्रीन आई हैव एन इमेज ऑफ अ सन एंड अ ग्लोब। चिल्ड्रेन, डिड यू रिकॉल something that we had already studied? Yes, in chapter number 4 we studied about different zones, that is torrid zone, which is also called as tropical zone, then temperate zone and frigid zone or polar zone. And in chapter number 5 we studied about DRC, land of dense forest, okay, which lies in the torrid zone. Okay, so children, in today's session we are going to know more about a country. Now which country? So we will travel to that country and study in detail. So I am traveling, I am going, are you going to join me? Okay, so do you know to which country are we going to travel? You don't know. Fine, I'll just give a clue. I have packed my bag with all the winter wear. Okay. That is muffler, jacket, gloves, scarf, socks, monkey cap, etc. So children, I know that you are very much excited to know to which country we are going to travel, isn't it? Did you guess to which country are we going to travel? And that country is in which zone? Did you guess? Yes. Now, from tropical zone or from torrid zone, we are going to travel to the frigid zone or to the polar zone. So, children, polar zone or the frigid zone, as we have studied, it is very much cold because the sun's rays fall very slanting, as it is shown in the image. So which kind of clothes do we require there? Yes, we require there woolen clothes. Okay, so I have packed my bag with all the woolen wear. Okay, so in frigid zone there are many countries such as Alaska, Sweden, Finland, Greenland, etc. So now to which place or to which country are we going to travel, children? We are going to travel to Greenland. Are you going to join with me, children? Yes. So today, instead of traveling, we'll just learn in detail about chapter number 6, that is Greenland, the land of ice and snow. Children, just imagine that we are going to travel, but we will sit in our own place itself. On the screen, we will see about this country. Okay, see the image itself. Tell that this country is full of snow, full of ice. Okay, so about this country, we are going to know more about its location, its climate, vegetation, wildlife, the people, agriculture, and industries. So, children, we will be heading to Greenland and will be experiencing some of the icy and cold weather now. So what is Greenland? Greenland is the largest island in the world, but it is not a continent. Okay, so Greenland is the largest island in the world that is not a continent. It is a self-governing province of Denmark. Okay, children, what do you mean by self-governing? Self-governing means exercising control over one's own affair. That is, they are having their own rule. Okay, so it is a self-governing province of Denmark. Its capital is Nuuk. Earlier, it was known as Gotland. Okay, so what is the capital of Greenland? Nuuk, or earlier it was known as Gotland. Okay, now children, do you know that who was the first person to visit this place? The first person who visited this place was Erik the Red. Okay, the first European who visited Greenland was an explorer called Erik the Red. He was the person to give the name of the island as Greenland. Okay, now children, let us know various features of Greenland. Features of Greenland. Number one is location. Now, where does Greenland exactly lie on this globe? Did you all see, children? Greenland lies here. Okay, that is in frigid zone. And the Arctic Circle passes through this Greenland. That is through the southern part of Greenland. Okay, Arctic Circle passes through the southern part of Greenland. Most of Greenland, therefore, lies in the frigid zone, that is near to the pole in the northern hemisphere. Children, you have already read that this region has a very cold climate, and the region is also known as tundra region. Okay, this region is also called as tundra region. Okay, children, the same is given here on the screen. Let us read together aloud. As the Arctic Circle is passing through the southern part, that is here, okay, most of Greenland lies in the frigid zone of the northern hemisphere, and this region is called as tundra region. Okay, 80% of Greenland always covered with ice. Okay, how much percent is covered with ice and snow? That is 80% of Greenland is always covered with ice. Here is the image, children. So if you turn towards your right or towards your left throughout the year, you will find only snow and ice. Sometimes these huge pieces of ice breaks off and float on the sea, and they are called as iceberg. Okay, sometimes these huge pieces of ice breaks off and float on the sea, and they are called as icebergs. And here is the image. Okay, children, here is the image of iceberg. Here the icebergs look small from above. Okay, but it's a really huge mass from below, which is very irregular in shape. So if any ship go and dashes against this iceberg, then children, you can imagine what damage it could make. Now children, on the screen here we have is RMS Titanic steamship. Okay, when the Titanic hit the iceberg close to midnight on April 14th 1912, okay, that is on 14th April 1912, it created a 300 foot long line of damage. Children, just imagine. The ship collided at the high speed with an iceberg, and around 2,240 passengers and crew were on board. And children, it was very sad that more than 1,500 passengers, included men, women, as well as children, lost their lives in this disaster. So children, on this incident, we even have a movie called Titanic. I don't know whether you have seen or not. If you get a chance, definitely watch this movie. Okay? Now children, let us see the another feature of Greenland, that is climate of Greenland. Now we know that most of Greenland comes under the frigid zone. That is why it is mostly covered with snow and ice. Whereas there is also a warm part like southwestern, okay, southwestern coast of Greenland, which is the warmest part of the country. And because it is the warmest part of the country, most of the people generally live here in this zone. Okay, so this is the region where the people dwell. Okay, that is southwestern coast of Greenland. Okay, so children, that's it with our today's session about Greenland. We studied about the location and its climate. Okay, in our next two sessions, we shall learn more about vegetation of Greenland, its wildlife, the people, agriculture and industries. Okay, in detail we'll be learning about these all features. Okay, so till then, do take care of yourself, read the textbook. Okay, be safe. Goodbye, take care.